Ed Woodward will leave Manchester United by the end of this month. It's confirmed. His current deputy and flight enthusiast, Richard Arnold, takes over. Jules, to many, Woodward is a source of all problems at the club. So surely this will fix everything, right?
Yeah, of course. Just like this. Hey, Ed is out and his twin brother is in. So what do you expect? I think Richard Arnold is very similar to Ed Woodward. I still don't think they're the right profile for this kind of job, but Arnold might prove me wrong. But with Woodward, he was a great servant to the club in his first role and bringing a lot of revenue in, not so much in the second part of his or second job that he had at that club. This is Manchester United. Well, and this is a huge, huge job.
There's still a ton of revenue coming in, which I think is part of the reason why the Glazers really aren't too bothered and the enterprise value of the club keeps going up. So, hey, whatever. I'm wondering, I don't know Richard Arnold. I generally mistrust
people.
No, but
you know the background and everything.
I know the background, and I know that he's been Ed's friend forever since they lived above the sofa shop and on the Fulham Road in London. I think it was the New King's Road, actually, in London. But, and I'm naturally mistrustful of people with two first names, like Richard Arnold. They're just not really appropriate. That said, I'm imagining Richard Arnold's like, all right, I'm stepping into the big chair. I'm going to get all the crap that was thrown at Ed. I still get to make the definitive decisions. Maybe I should be more aware of my weaknesses, perhaps, or the people who are negotiating deals, or the people who are identifying talent. Maybe, since I have the clout now, I should go tell the Glazers, hey, I'm going to handle all the operations and everything. I'm going to approve the budgets, do all the commercial stuff like I was doing before, and I'll be the big boss. But I'm going to get somebody who really knows what they're doing to head up the football side. It might not be Ralph Rangnick.
Yeah.
And I'm just wondering. I'm going to go. I think that's what Richard Arnold should do.
I'm
you agree, right?
Optimism so far.
No, but you agree that that's what Arnold should do.
Yeah.
He's still the big boss.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering. I can think of somebody who's won accolades left, right, and center, who's considered a footballing. A football management genius who is about 30 miles down the road at another really big club, a rival club, in fact, and who after 10 years is leaving that club. Would it just be like the ultimate villain story if they went, if they announced Michael Edwards as the new, that wouldn't happen. Yeah?
I don't know. That would be
I'm just chucking
special.
It out there. That would be bold. I don't think it would ever happen. No. But it would be bold. You heard it here first.
Gab, the fallout from talking about United, the fallout from Ralph Rangnick's first defeat on Monday night at Old Trafford against Wolves continues to dominate the headlines. But according to reports, United are ready to spend in January. So all good, yeah?
Yeah, so there's a very funny thing that happens in the media, right? And you saw this. You saw this ahead of Conte's return to Spurs when everybody had a deep dive into Conte and Chelsea and what went wrong. And that's fine, right?
Yeah.
But they all had the same stories because it's the same people briefing the same stories. And we see it with United, right? Everybody's just like, oh, United have 17 players they want to get rid of, you know, either because contracts expire and so on, and Rangnick's going to clean house. Like, it's good that he has money to spend because they need to strengthen.
Yeah.
But you need to also realize he's not the permanent manager. So this is a difficult thing, right? Personally, as a club, I wouldn't say if Rangnick goes and says, like, yeah, I need somebody to do the pressing here, like Sabitzer and blah, 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 and this guy can do that. I would say, Ralph, we may have
but
a completely
isn't that
different
part of the problem then. Even for the players, even within the dressing room, that you know that when he talks, he might not be there in 4 months' time.
You nailed it. And that's fine. He's an interim boss. Act like an interim boss.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.